absence of good relations has produced crisis of trust, which if care is not taken, can destroy not only our party, but the political process. So as leaders whose concerns, we need to make amends, especially in the area of management of political relations across all blocks of party stakeholders. We need not to remind ourselves of what happened between 2015 and 2019. We, unfortunately, allowed avoidable circumstances to give new life to our political opponents, especially parties in opposition to APC, like PDP. We have not managed our personal aspirations to contest elections through the inability of our party leadership to painstakingly ensure broad consultations leading to collective decisions that are the causes of most of these avoidable circumstances. We know what had happened, the build-up to 2019, the crisis we have in so many states, within our own political party. I'm sure this paragraph in particular is referring to those crises that could have been avoided. Recognizing that conflicting demands from all stakeholders will not be easy to manage, compliance with provisions of our party's constitution and all relevant laws of Nigeria would have.
Excellency the President of the Senate, Excellency the Speaker.
We intend to remain very resolute. We intend to remain very loyal to the party and the principles the party stands for. We intend to remain committed and dedicated to Nigerian ideals of making sure that Nigeria provides all the necessary services to citizens, and especially when it comes to the area of ensuring the security, safety, and welfare of citizens. It is necessary that the two levels, in fact, all the levels of government work together. We have certain issues that we cannot do alone at the national level. When we have to take out 11, 12, or 13, or even 14 million children out of school, off the streets, the federal government cannot do that alone. This is something that I think the two levels of government, particularly the states and the federal government, will have to work together. And the states, I want to assure our governors here, you have partners in the National Assembly. We believe that we can do far better, we can do more when we work together, and we are here representing the states.
Those of us on this side, the National Assembly, I'm a little bit perturbed and surprised that adjournment will be given against the explicit constitutional rules of the National Assembly as prescribed in Section 12 of the Constitution, which is written in very unambiguous language. We're a bit concerned that, of course, there are three arms of government, and we will, to serve notice, be going to court on this matter to resolve it, not just for this moment, but for the future, so that issues like that do not come up again as one party. There's so much expected of us in this government. We are going to need one another. It's going to have to be a symbiotic relationship between the governors and the legislators. And that's what we look forward to. We'll probably have a more robust conversation after the press has gone out and we've had the presentation.